Good morning, everyone. Welcome to the first episode of the Avocado Insider series. It's your host, Harshad Godha. Avocado Insider is a different series from my blogs because इस series में मैं avocado industry के experts से discussion करके industry के insights आप लोगों से share करूँ. मैंने recently एक virtual meeting host की थी जिसमें Netafim Israel and Netafim India के experts थे and मेरे एक customer थे जिनको irrigation के questions थे. उस मीटिंग की समरी अभी आपकी स्क्रीन पे आ जाएगी. समरी में जितने भी पॉइंट्स बताए हैं वो हमने डिटेल में डिस्कस किए थे.
So if I want to summarize this presentation, we need to choose a good variety, high population, spacing between 5 to 7 between rows, 3 to 4 meters between trees, drip irrigation and nutrigation, induction of flowering, we need a low temperature to get the flowering. We need to add pollinator variety. Most of the variety from type B. Type A will be that the pollinator variety, you should use something like Ettinger, Fuerte, and there are other variety also. We have to do pruning. In all this, we'll get easy harvesting and management. In case of heat or frost danger, we need to use frost and heat mitigation.
ये सारे points of discussion का मैं एक separate video बना के इनको individually आपसे हर Wednesday evening को अपने channel Indo Israel Avocado पे share करूँगा. So please subscribe ताकि आपको हर video हर वीक आपको दिखता जाए एंड आप उससे इंफॉर्मेशन गैदर करते जाए. मेरे अरुणाचल प्रदेश के एक कस्टमर जिनने मुझे 700 प्लांट्स का ऑर्डर दिया था, वो अपनी फील्ड पे इंपोर्टेड प्लांट्स एंड लोकल इंडियन एवोकाडो वैरायटीज भी उगा रहे हैं. उन्होंने उसके लिए अपनी फील्ड पे रेस बेड्स तैयार किए थे. इनकी फील्ड पे पहले राइस पैडी का कल्टीवेशन होता था, तो रेस बेड्स बनाना बहुत ज़रूरी था बिकॉज राइस एक ऐसी फसल है जिसमें पानी को रोक के रखा जाता है, जबकि अगर एवोकाडो के फील्ड पे अगर पानी रुकता है तो एवोकाडो का पौधा मर सकता है, तो इसलिए वहाँ पे रेस बेड्स बनाना बहुत ज़रूरी था. हमारा इस बारे में पूरा डिस्कशन अभी आपकी स्क्रीन पर आ जाए. सो स्टे ट्यून्ड. एंड एट
मगान to learn about avocado farming from a farmer called Benjamin Weiss. And then I met Ziv over there. And then since then, I've been focusing my activities in India. I've purchased avocado plants from Israel, and plants are currently in my nursery in Madhya Pradesh right now. And I've also started distributing the plants. I'm planning to start the distribution of plants in the near future. So that's how I met, I contacted Nani Ruja. And he's purchasing some plants from me. He's from Arunachal Pradesh. It's in the northeast of India.
Okay, next.
Guys.
Thank you. You are on a mute. I think you want to speak something. You are on a mute.
Hello.
Yeah.
So, good morning, everyone. My name is Nani Ruja myself, and this is my dad. And we are the ones who are requiring the assistance. So thank you all very much for providing the assistance. And so would you like to start with the presentation, or should we?
Can you say a few words about you? What are you growing? How big is your plant? What are your plans in the future? What are you already growing?
Okay. Our place, as I wrote you on the mail, Mr. Ziv, an area of 5.5 hectares, but the cultivable area is around 4.6. So we are going for mostly the Indian variety, and about you can say 60 to 70% will be Indian variety. But the rest, yeah, avocado. The rest are around 700 plants, which we have already ordered with Harshit. And those are the Israel variety. So, yeah, we are going through the process of arranging everything right now, but everything is not set up. And right now, still we are working on it. And we needed some help regarding the estimation of the water quantities. So a rough idea we have, like I asked Mr. Mehdi, the Northeast representative here, and he made an estimate, but it was like a large volume, like 80 liters per tree, 80 liters. So I asked you, like, can we reduce it, like, as per the requirements here? So you suggested of around 65 liters, right? And then and also you were recommending uniram instead of the pressure PCJ drippers. So regarding that, like, what kind of stuff would you like to tell us? Is there a presentation or something?
Yes, there is a presentation. Just one more question. Today you are already growing something?
No. No, we have just planted around 22 seedlings, and we are just observing like how they are doing.
Are you growing anything else, like wheat, banana, tomato?
Nothing.
Are you farming?
Yeah, it will be completely avocado.
What is your? You don't have a history of agriculture.
No.
Basically, it was a paddy field. It was a paddy field, wet rice cultivation field. We have not cultivated paddy anymore there. We have let it drain away. We have managed to drain away the water stagnation for last summer season, this rainy season. It's all channelized, and the drainage system is done. And we are now, immediate requirement is the water supply system to each of the plants as you may prescribe. And the total plan that we have built rows, what we call the bands and this.
Exactly. So
we should have been able to present the current look of the ground. I have pictures in my mobile phone. I do not know how to show you that. Maybe my son will try doing something. If you look at our current position of the field, maybe you can visualize something and may be able to prescribe something. And as about anything standing in the entire plot, now we have just 22 avocado plants. We do not know the parental signature of the plant, the variety. But we have 1.5 year old 22 avocado plants that we got germinated at our home itself, and the seeds and the fruits were brought from Mizoram, another northeastern state of Arunachal, means India. Mizoram, it came from Mizoram. So we brought up fruit somewhere in January 20. Then got germinated around March, April, and grown to something like 1.5 feet tall by August 21. We planted it out into the field in August 21, and it is now about 2 meters high and all very healthy.
We're
not exactly using any kind of scientific irrigation system for watering, but my fellow down there in the field usually waters about a bucket full of water to each plant every morning. And last 1 year, we have tried without giving water. We don't see any change in its coloration of the leaves and all. I just visited yesterday itself, and it seems it's all healthy.
So,
you didn't graft it?
No. It's not grafted. It's just seedlings. Yeah. So they germinated from the seeds and they are just growing naturally. Like we are not giving any kind of fertilizer or anything. We are just doing some manuring and stuff like which is available there, like cow dung, manuring, and all those only, like very natural. And we are trying to mulch whatever is possible, but it's fairly natural. There is no added anything. And watering is just like, yeah, the guy over there, he will just spray over using a hose and nothing else. So later on, planting such a large volume, like a large number, will be like watering will be difficult. That's why we require some proper system.
Yeah, okay. Something.
Yes.
Yeah. So regarding the plants that I'm supplying to them, those are all imported from Israel. The varieties are Pinkerton, Ettinger, Reed, Haas, and Lambhas, with majority being Haas and Lambhas. And the rootstocks are, I'm offering multiple rootstocks to them to figure out which rootstock is going to perform the best. The rootstocks are Degania 117, Ashdod 17, and Day.
Okay. Thank you, Ashish. Just one question, guys. Before we start, I want to be sure that I understood correctly. Before you planted the avocado, it was rice paddy?
Yes. Yeah, it was originally rice paddy.
Have you made between the rice paddy and planting avocado? Have you made any? Wait a minute. Have you made any soil cultivation? Have you made ridges? Or you just planted?
No. We have done the complete soil work. Like we changed the entire soil profile. We what we did was it was a bit because of the previous hello yeah because of the previous paddy cultivation. Like it was done for over many years. The region was quite swampy. So what we did was we carried some sand from the nearby river, like lots of sand, and we did an entire excavation thing there. So the entire soil profile has been changed now, and it's very sandy loam. Like even if you dig everywhere, it's sandy loam type. So it's not like the paddy area. And now there is no paddy over there, and it's completely
Have you built raised beds?
Yes. And the height of the beds are around, you can say, 2 feet. And they are wide about 2 meters, and yeah, they are like long berms. If I can show you the photo again, which I sent to you. Just a second, let me. okay. Am I sharing my screen? Can you see my screen? Yeah. Yes. So let me zoom. Yeah, so if you see here, no, this thing is obstructing my Yeah. So this is the land you can see, like, so you can see that the berms have been laid along this direction, and why it is seeing as different profiles here. Like there is a larger area of green vegetation coverage. Actually, that is completely weed. Weed, and we have completely removed it, and this is like the open berms which you are seeing here. If you can see here, these are the open berms, and the distance between them is around 4.5 meters, so around 15 feet. And that's it. Those are the raised beds which you can see as shadows and highlights.
Okay.
And if you can see here, these are the 22 plants which we have planted. So these are the native species of Mizoram which are available, and we planted them just to see like how they react.
I hope you found our discussion useful. This was just the introduction. We'll dive deep into the climatic requirements of avocado farming with Netafim next week on Wednesday. Please subscribe. That's it for this video. Thank you for watching.